There weren't a lot, honestly. It was, wow, this is exciting. What a rare cancer. Let's talk about how exceptional that is. And let's send you off to Toronto to this person who specializes in these cancers. And then from there, too, I felt like I was really underprepared for how I was going to feel after the surgery. The treatment that I had is quite unusual or rare, I guess. I don't know if you've heard of HIPEC. It's hypothermic intraperitoneal chemotherapy. So basically, I had an 18-hour surgery that included chemotherapy. And so they go in and they remove everything surgically. And then while you're still open, they fill you with scalding hot liquid that kind of then burns everything. And into that, they put the chemicals that then chemically burn everything and hopefully get the invisible stuff, like the stuff that was too small to see. But so they cut you and then they burn you twice and they leave it in you. And it just kind of absorbs into your system. So everything turns into a big mat of scar tissue. So the pain of it has been something that I've really had to learn to live with. I have constant nerve pain in my abdomen. And the other stuff that is awful is the digestional issues. Oh, it's been so bad. It's so bad sometimes because I guess when you have that many resections, they just don't recover. And, you know, they kept saying, you know, give it a year. And at the year mark, I was like, things aren't any better. They're like, oh, it's still early days. Give it another year. And now I'm at 3.5 years realizing that this is just how it is. And yeah, it's not. I went from a person who worked 3 jobs and went out 2 or 3 nights a week to someone who can't work because I'm way too unreliable and my immune system is impossible and I get tired so easy and I have this machine I have to bring with me, and it's a big shift, and I felt like I wasn't prepared for that beforehand. I think part of that is that my cancer is a cancer that most doctors don't see in their careers, and sometimes I feel like when I end up in front of a new doctor, they're really interested in it, but sometimes I get lost as a patient in that. And so I really feel like I was underprepared. But I have been lucky to connect with therapists since that have really helped me, like through mindfulness mostly, and through learning to advocate for myself in those situations, how to just kind of live with this a bit more comfortably, I guess is the word.